Good morning students, let's start our next chapter, that is ammonia. Ammonia is NH3. Its structure, dot structure we have done in chapter 2. And what kind of bond is between ammonia? That is covalent bond. Why? Because nitrogen is non-metal, hydrogen is also non-metal. So type of bond between ammonia is that covalent bond. Next thing is occurrence of ammonia. It occurs in combined state as well as in free state. Next, laboratory preparation of ammonia. Laboratory preparation. In laboratory preparation, there should be ammonium chloride. This is laboratory preparation. Structure is there, diagram. Ammonium chloride, when reacts with calcium hydroxide in the presence of when it is heated, then calcium chloride, water and ammonia is the product. Now see this diagram. This is round bottom flask contains calcium hydroxide and ammonium chloride. Calcium hydroxide, ammonium chloride, and this is the source of heat. Now what will happen when they all will react? They both will react. Calcium chloride and calcium chloride will remain here, and water vapor will collect here near to the mouth of round bottom flask. And ammonia will pass from round bottom flask to this container, and then it is collected by downward displacement of air. This method is called downward displacement of air. And quicklime, calcium oxide, it will act as a drying agent. It helps to dry ammonia, and finally ammonia will be collected in the gas jar. And another, this is laboratory preparation reaction. We can also prepare ammonia from the another ammonium salt. So whenever the question is asked, write the laboratory reaction. You will write this reaction only. This is another reaction by which we can prepare ammonia. From ammonium sulfate, potassium hydroxide, we can take another alkali, potassium hydroxide, heating potassium sulfate, then ammonia and water is removed. And the precautions, what is the precaution? This flask should be tilted. Its mouth, you can see that it is tilted. Why? So that water will not trickle back to the flask. That's why it is tilted. Then drying agent for ammonia, it is calcium oxide. We cannot choose a drying agent like concentrated sulfuric acid, phosphorus pentoxide and calcium chloride. As the nature of ammonia, it is basic in nature due to the presence of lone pair on nitrogen. It is basic. Collection, already I have explained, it is collected by downward displacement of air. Why downward displacement of air? Because it is lighter than air. Its vapor density is 8.5 times, but vapor density of air is 14.4. Next one is note. A higher ratio of calcium hydroxide is preferred. High ratio of alkali is preferred. Why? Because ammonium chloride, it is sublime, so that it can react completely with the ammonium chloride. Its ratio should be higher, because ammonium chloride is a sublime. Sublimation may occur. Next one is calcium hydroxide is chosen because it is cheap. Next, instead of ammonium chloride, we can take another ammonium compound, but we cannot take ammonium nitrate and ammonium nitrite, because they will not give you ammonia gas, and ammonium nitrate is explosive in nature. Next one is we can also prepare ammonia from nitrides, metal nitrides, that is aluminium nitride and magnesium nitride. But for the laboratory preparation, that reaction should be there, ammonium chloride and calcium hydroxide. Another preparation from magnesium nitride. Nitride is 3-2 plus warm water is added. Then what can be the product? Ammonia must be there. We are doing the preparation of ammonia plus another product. You can find from the magnesium and water is there. So what is the another product? That is magnesium hydroxide. And balance the equation. You will put here 3 and now it is not balanced, put here I think 6 will be there, yes, now it is, and 2 ammonia, now it is balanced. You can also do the reaction with aluminium and balance it. It is, you can do from page number 153, same is there. Next one is preparation of aqueous ammonia. Like in chapter 8 you have done the preparation of hydrochloric acid from hydrogen chloride gas. There will be back section and all same things are here for the ammonia. Just instead of hydrogen chloride gas, there is ammonia gas. When ammonia gas dissolves in water, then it gives ammonium hydroxide, or you can say aqueous ammonia. So do it by yourself. And next one is, this is manufacture. Manufacture means preparation of ammonia on the larger scale. Manufacture is done by, you are very much familiar with Haber's process. This one is diagram of Haber's process. Nitrogen and hydrogen, what is the reaction? Nitrogen and hydrogen, and it gives ammonia 2, and here is 3. Now it is balanced. And what are the condition? Temperature must be 450 to 500 degrees Celsius, and plus heat. It is exothermic reaction, heat. And then pressure. Pressure will be above what you have done before in lower classes, 200 atmosphere. Catalyst, four condition, remember, four conditions are there. Finally divided iron. And promoter, what is promoter? It increases the efficiency of catalyst. Promoter is either aluminium oxide, or you can say molybdenum. Okay, and here we will see how this process occurs. Now the source of nitrogen is when we do the fractional distillation of air, we can get nitrogen. And the source of hydrogen is water gas, or you can obtain it from natural gas. So what will happen when we enter these two gases? There is compressor. Both the gases will compress, then will pass to the catalytic chamber. In catalytic chamber, this catalyst is present, promoter is there, temperature is maintained up to this, and pressure is above 200. All these conditions are satisfied here in this. Now what will happen? They all will combine, and then this is coolant. Here from this side water, cold water is entered, and from this side hot water will go. So what will happen here? Ammonia gas and other two gases which are not combined will come here, and then will cool down, and ammonia will change into liquid form that will be obtained from the downside. And those gases which are not nitrogen, hydrogen, it is not easily liquefied. So these will remain in the gaseous form. They will not come down in the liquid form. So what will happen? These two gases will go from this circulating pipes again to the compressor. Again, these gases will be nitrogen and hydrogen, which are not combined. Again, this will come down to the catalytic chamber. Again, this process will be there. And from this process, we can get 98% ammonia. And one thing more, this is exothermic reaction. So once it is heated, this starting heating is needed. And once the temperature is attained, then after that we can stop the source of heating. Another thing is that high pressure, why high pressure is required? Because when you see the product ratio, reactant ratio, it is 1 to 3, total 4. And here you are getting only 2. Means less amount of ammonia. So this favors the high pressure. This favors the high pressure. Next one is the catalyst should be removed. The catalyst should be free from impurities such as carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, or sulfur compounds. Otherwise, it will make the catalyst poison. It will catalyst poison will be there if we will not remove the impurities from nitrogen and hydrogen. Next one is fountain experiment. In fountain experiment, this is all about Hebbers process. Very important. Four conditions are very, very important. Keep it in mind. Next one, fountain experiment. As you have done for HCl gas fountain experiment, that is acidic in nature and ammonia is basic in nature. Just the difference is that this fountain experiment shows the solubility of a gas. And here the difference is that in trough we will take red litmus. There for HCl we have taken blue litmus solution, and here we will take red litmus solution. Rest all the things are similar to HCl. So go through from that portion, chapter 8. And next one is properties of ammonia. Properties of ammonia. First property is burning of ammonia. Burning of ammonia. Burning means it will react with oxygen, NH3 plus O2. The product will be N2 plus H2O. And the balancing is very important. 4, 3, and here will be 2, and for hydrogen 12, and here will be 6. 4, 3, 2, 6. Yes. So this is burning without any catalyst. Remember the product nitrogen and water, and after that balance. And next thing is, what do you observe here? You will observe when ammonia, it burns with the greenish yellow flame. It is very important. What is the observation? When ammonia burns in oxygen, it burns with the greenish yellow flame. Next one is catalytic oxidation. Catalytic oxidation of ammonia. Now oxidation again, addition of oxygen. Catalytic means presence of a catalyst. Platinum temperature 800, around 800 degrees Celsius. So what will be the product? Nitric oxide plus water. This is the product, and balance it. 5, here will be 4, and water, how many water are there? 6. Plus heat, exothermic reaction. Then further, this nitric oxide combined with oxygen, it will give nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide, again balance. This one, is it balanced? Yes, it is balanced. Now what is the color of nitrogen dioxide? It is brown gas. What do you observe during the catalytic oxidation of ammonia? Brown gas, brown colored gas, that is nitrogen dioxide, is formed. These both are very important. If the burning of ammonia is there, observation is different. If catalytic oxidation is there, observation is different. And reactions are also very important. Just learn it. Next thing is third one, reducing nature of ammonia. Reducing nature of ammonia, NH3. So NH3 we will do with the help of copper oxide compound. So what will do ammonia will do? It will remove oxygen, reducing na. So ammonia will remove this oxygen from the copper oxide. So copper oxide will change into copper plus water is there, and nitrogen gas. Copper, water and nitrogen gas. Balance it. Ammonia, here is 2, yes, 2, is it balance? 3 water, and this one gas. Again in this observation is there, its color is black and its color reddish brown. The compound, copper oxide black compound will change into, will be reduced into reddish brown copper metal. Clear? Ammonia, why it is reducing? Because it can remove oxygen from copper oxide. We can also write the reaction with lead oxide in the similar way. Instead of copper, there will be lead. Next one is very important reaction. These all reactions are very important. Few reactions are there in this chapter and very important. The fifth one is reaction of ammonia with chlorine. Here the two cases are there. When chlorine is in excess and chlorine is in little amount. So reaction of ammonia with chlorine. First case, it is the when ammonia is in excess, when NH3 is in excess, means large amount, and chlorine is in small amount. Here will be NH3 plus Cl2. Remember the product, afterwards you can balance. Remember the product. Here the product will be nitrogen gas and ammonium chloride. And second, when chlorine is in excess. Okay, so just remember the product. Here is HCl plus NCl3. Now you can balance the equation. Here will be 8. Here is 3, 8, 3, then 6. Here will be 3, no, not here 3. Here is 3, then it will take time. That's why I'm seeing from the book directly. So when you will do the hit and trial method, you can easily balance the equation. Without balancing, your equations are not corrected. So remember, when ammonia is in excess, what are the product? Reactant will be same, ammonia chlorine, ammonium chlorine, nitrogen gas and ammonium chloride. When chlorine is in excess, hydrogen chloride gas and nitrogen trichloride. Now observation, what is the observation in second case? In second case, yellow colored liquid, that is nitrogen trichloride, is formed. Here is the observation only. Next one is when ammonia react with ammonia gas. Easily you can give answer, you have done this many time. Ammonia and HCl gas together give a solid. Two gases gives a solid, that is NH4Cl, ammonium chloride solid. And next one is reaction of aqueous ammonia with acid. Now this is all about ammonia gas. Now aqueous ammonia. Aqueous ammonia means aqueous. What do you understand by aqueous means? Aqueous ammonia. It is NH3 plus water. It will give ammonium hydroxide. This is aqueous ammonia. So reaction of ammonia with acid, aqueous ammonia with acid, base acid, what are the products? Salt and water, neutralization reaction, only salt and water, ammonium chloride and water. Then again, if we take sulfuric acid, H2SO4, can you give the answer? Which ammonium sulfate and water will be there? It is given on book on page number 158. Next one is test of ammonia. Ammonia has characteristic smell, that is pungent choking smell, and it can change red litmus to blue. Next, it can also change turmeric paper brown, and phenolphthalein solution, which is colorless, then ammonium hydroxide can change phenolphthalein colorless to pink color. Next one is another test. This is chemical test, NH3 plus HCl. Both gases, when ammonia gas reacts with HCl gas, it gives white fumes of ammonium chloride. This is chemical test. Next one is ammonia when passes through copper sulfate solution. This we have done in fourth chapter. Some of the reaction I have skipped because we have completed in fourth chapter. Which reactions are those? Reaction of aqueous solution of ammonia with soluble metal salt on page number 158. So you can do from fourth chapter these all reactions. And fourth test also we have done over there. Ammonia when passes from copper sulfate, first it will give blue precipitate. After that, when we add in excess ammonia gas, blue precipitate will dissolve and give blue solution, deep blue solution. Next one is ammonia, it turns Nessler solution brown. This is the chemical test of ammonia, as well as this test, that litmus test, phenolphthalein and odor test, these all are physical tests. But this one is chemical, then Nestle reagent test is chemical, copper sulfate solution, that is chemical. Next one, last one is uses of ammonia. So ammonia, it is used as a refrigerant in ice plants. Now why it acts as a refrigerant? Because it require a lot of energy to vaporize. When it changes to vapor, it needs a lot of energy. And from where it will get energy? From the surrounding. Surrounding will be cooled down and ammonia will vaporize. And another refrigerant used is CFC, chlorofluorocarbon. But it has disadvantage. Like chlorofluorocarbon, it can deplete our ozone layer. And so it leads to global warming. And next one is advantages of ammonia. Why it is used as a refrigerant? In which system it is used, in which refrigerant it is used, that system will get only less electricity. So it will consume less electricity and it does not lead to the depletion of ozone layer, ammonia. And next one is disadvantages of ammonia. Why we cannot use? One disadvantage is there. Some ammonia is not used. We cannot use ammonia in the copper tubes. Ammonia as a refrigerant, we cannot use if the system has copper tubes, because both can react. And the next one is ammonia. It is used to dissolve fat. So it can be used as a cleansing agent. It can remove the stains from the clothes, or we can also clean tiles with the ammonia. Next one is, it is used to prepare nitrogenous fertilizers. And next one is explosives like ammonium nitrate, ammonium nitrate is formed from the ammonia. It is the compound of ammonia, ammonium nitrate, and it acts as a explosive. The last use is, it is used to prepare nitric acid, and the process is called Ostwald process. It's a very important name, in by which process nitric acid is formed. The name is Ostwald process. So these are some uses of ammonia compound, and please go through from this whole chapter and revise the each and every reaction. And try to solve exercise. Thank you.